Hello, welcome to Enots Engineering. I'm Alan. Today we're looking at this digital height gauge from Banggood. It's a 6-inch height gauge, 150mm. It says on the box, metric display, inch display and fractional display, but there is no fractional display on this height gauge. I think they use the same box for different models. And it says on the back for woodworking, but it's the same type of caliper used as you would use for metalworking. Same resolution. So let's go into the workshop and see how it works. This is a 6-inch or 150mm digital height gauge from Banggood. So inside the box you get this polystyrene packaging, and inside that you get the height gauge. Now I've removed all the packaging, let's take a closer look. You have a zero button, an on-off button, and an inch or millimetre button. On metric, you have two decimal places. And on imperial, it gives you the reading of thous, and then every half a thou. This is the measuring face, and if you need to sharpen the edge for scribing lines, you sharpen it on this side, not on the measuring face. Now, if we compare the other end, the height gauge does not have the rod for measuring the depth of holes. And on the other end, the height gauge has a cast iron block to stand it on. I've taken the battery cover off, and the battery was already fitted when it arrived. The battery is a larger battery, it's a CR2032, and above that is access for a digital cable connection. Now, to use this, you need to stand it on a flat base. Here I'm using a surface plate, but you could use your milling machine table. Move the arm down and set it to zero. Once set to zero, you can lift the arm and place the part that you wish to measure. In this case, I'm using a 30mm gauge block. Apply some pressure to the end of the caliper to make sure it's down. And there's the reading, 30mm. The end of the arm has a knife edge, so you can use that to scribe a line. Turn the block around and do the other side. Now, as the part's small, I can just pull it in front of the scriber to scribe the line. And of course, if you need to be higher, you can always place the height gauge on top of a V-block or parallel strips to give you the extra height, and just take the height of the V-block into account. Now I've moved to the lathe, and what I want to do is check how high my compound slide is to the centre of the lathe chuck. I've placed a piece of 15mm silver steel in the chuck. So if I get the height gauge, put the height gauge on my compound slide, and lower it down to the face. Zero the reading, and once it's zero on the face of the compound slide, I can turn it back around towards the chuck. Touch it on the top of the bar. This bar's 15mm silver steel. Let's have a look at the reading, and that's showing 32.88. Now, if I take 7.5mm off, which is half the diameter of the bar, it will give me 25.38 from the centre of the chuck to the face. Now, if I check my tool height gauge, which is this, I'll take the bottom part off the dial indicator. That height should be the same as 25.38. Slacken the screw off, move it down, and it's 25.46. So I'm a little over on that at 0.08. That's to the top of this block. So that is about 3 thou oversize. Well, I'll leave it at that for the moment. This is my tool height adjustment gauge. It comprises of that part, which is just a block, a face on center line, hole through, and a small washer, which gives you a lip to put the tool underneath, and the dial indicator, so it just sticks out the bottom. When that goes on there, I can zero that with the dial indicator. Put my tool post back on. I slide my tool height gauge over the top of the tool and adjust the height of the tool until the dial indicator just moves. That's it. So I know now that that tool is set to the height of that block, which is 3 thou over the centre line. Well, that's a 6-inch or 150mm digital height gauge. That's all for today. Hope that was useful. Hope that was interesting. And we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.